Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over how to manage various resources inside of Microsoft Project. Now, these resources could include people, but they can also include material costs and any other costs that you might have for your project. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description. So let's revisit our party planning project just one more time. I've made a few changes on here, but the tasks are basically what we've been looking at the entire time. Sending invitations, shopping, prepping food, setting up, and having a party. But this time, I want to show you how to add resources to this. So if I go over here on the file ribbon under View where it says Gantt chart, I can select Resource Sheet. Now this resource sheet lets me do several different things. First, I can add people resources. Who's going to be doing the work? So let's say mom, she's always doing the work. Dad, let's say grandma is going to come one day and help with the cooking. If I look under this type field, I can see that I have three options here for either work, material, or cost. But I also have a few other resources going into this project. One would be food, and one would be decorations. And let's set both of those to material because they are things that we are buying for the party. So over here, I'm going to set a standard rate of $250 for food and $50 for decorations. Now I know mom, dad, and grandma are going to work for free, but let's just say we want to give them a rate of $50 an hour just so I can show you what will happen on our Gantt chart. So once I've put all my resources in, I'm going to go back to Gantt chart. And on here, there is a column right here for resource names. So when I shop for food, I'm going to check the food box. And when I shop for decorations, I'm going to check the decorations box. And I'm going to widen this up a bit and double click on here. And I'm going to scroll down to the field cost. And I can see right here that my cost is being calculated on the days where I add the resource. So this is a very, very helpful tool for tracking not only your tasks, but who's going to work on the task and also how much it's going to cost. And when you look over here in the Gantt chart, you can see where those resources are being used. So up here under resource names, let's say everybody is going to help fill out invitations. You can see that the cost field has been updated. And it assumes that each one of these people here is going to work for 4 hours. And then it calculates the cost based on each person's hourly rate here. So $50 times 4 for dad, $50 times 4 for grandma, and $50 times 4 for mom adds up to this $600 right here. So let's say on this day, dad is going to prep the burgers. And let's say mom is going to prep the appetizers this night. And then let's say here, grandma is going to make the cake and mom is going to make a salad. So now when I look over here, you can see that my resources have been added to each one of these tasks. So I can quickly look and see who is going to be doing each of these tasks. You can also see for each of these 2 hours, a rate has been put in based on the person's hourly rate. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos. So let's go over to here and go back to the resource sheet. I'm going to take out the hourly rates here because I just wanted to demonstrate how those would calculate your costs. But we know in reality, mom, dad, and grandma are working for free for this party. And then I'm going to go back to my Gantt chart. If I go to project, and I go to change working time. In this pull down box right here, I can choose any of my resources and when they can work. Right now, remember, we have everyone's working time from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. That's why we're only getting 2 hours a night. But let's say mom is not available to work on Wednesday night because she has to bring all of the other kids to their soccer practice. So I'm going to go down here in this grid and I'm going to select the 25th. And see how my calendar turns red? This is automatically set to a time that mom is unavailable. So if I say okay here, you can see that there is now a problem with my Gantt chart because mom has been moved to Thursday to do her task right here to prep appetizers because she's not going to be home on Wednesday night. But that has pushed out all of these tasks that come after because this task is a predecessor of the others. So either mom needs to be home on Wednesday night to do that work, or we can reassign this to someone else to do the work. So let's say grandma's going to switch with mom, and grandma will do work on Wednesday night, and mom will make the cake on Thursday night. So you can now see there's no red over here, so we're back to a schedule that's actually going to work. And right here, you can see I have 6 hours planned for decorate and setup and for the party. That's because when I edited this project earlier, I went up to change working time and I went over to the 28th and I hit these details and I changed the working hours from 12 p.m. to 8 p.m. to give more time on this day as an exception. So when I say okay, and if I click off the 28th, you can see that that is light blue, just like this over here. So it's an exception day. And that's why I'm allowed to have more than the 2 hours that I had scheduled by default for all of the other days. So as you're thinking about this, you can probably see that there are many, many other opportunities for putting in resources, especially when you have a project and you are considering people's hourly rates, as well as the expenses that come along with those tasks. This is a very simple example, but hopefully you'll be able to expand this to whatever your needs are for the project that you are working on. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. And as always, thanks for watching and see you again next time. If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.